आई संसाद अहमद, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री, डीएबी पीजी कॉलेज सिवान। टुडे आई हैव टू डिस्कस थर्ड लॉ ऑफ थर्मोडायनेमिक्स, नास्ट हीट थ्योरम्स एंड प्लैंक्स एक्सटेंशन ऑफ इट विल ओरिजिनली डिराइव फ्रॉम ऑब्जर्विंग द बिहेवियर ऑफ केमिकल रिएक्शन इन सॉलिड एंड लिक्विड्स इज नाउ बिलीव टू apply quite generally to any process, and in view of that it is time to reconsider our description of adiabatic demagnetization. We see immediately that need to be redraw to reflect the fact that the entropy of substance approaches zero whether or not it is situated in a magnetic field. The revised drawing is shown here, in which I have drawn three consecutive magnetizations, demagnetizations operations. And it will be readily seen that we shall never reach a temperature of exactly zero in a finite number of operations. The same applies to any operation in which we attempt to lower the temperature by a series of isothermal constants that decrease the entropy followed by adiabatic relaxations, whether we are compressing a gas isothermally and then decompressing it adiabatically, or stretching a rubber band isothermally and loosening it adiabatically. In all cases, owing to the convergence of the two entropy curves at zero temperature, we are led to conclude it is impossible to reduce the temperature of a material body to absolute zero of temperature in a finite number of operations. This is the third law of thermodynamics, and it is an inevitable sequence of Planck's extension of Nernst heat theorem. Just see the figures, no field, field against S and T. This is usually taken to mean that it is impossible ever to reduce the temperature of anything to absolute zero. From a practical point of view, that may be true, though that is not strictly what the third law say. It say that it is impossible to do it in a finite number of operation. I cannot help but think of a bouncing ball in which the ball bounces an infinite number of times before finally coming to rest after a finite times. After every bounce, there are still an infinite number of bounces yet to come. Yet it is all over in a finite times. Now perhaps some reader of these notes one day will devise a method of performing an infinite number of isothermal stress adiabatic relaxation operation in a finite time, and so attain absolute zero. The third law also talk about a finite number of operation by which I take it is meant operations such as an entropy reducing constraints followed by an adiabatic relaxation. I am not sure to what extent this applies to processes such as laser cooling. In such experiment, a laser beam is directed opposite to an atomic beam. The laser frequency is exactly equal to the frequency need to excite the atom to their lowest excited level, and so it stops the atom in their tracks. As the atom slows down, the required frequency can be changed to allow for the Doppler effect. Such experiments have reduced the temperature to a fraction of a nanokelvin. These experiments do not seem to be of the sort of experiment we had in mind when developing the third law of thermodynamics. We might well ask ourselves if it is conceptually possible or impossible to reduce the speed of a collection of atoms to zero for a finite period of time. We might argue that it is conceptually possible, but then we may remember that atoms attract each other, so if all the atoms are instantaneously at rest, they will not remain so. Of course, if we had an ideal gas such that there are no forces between the molecules, the concept of zero temperature implies that all the atoms are stationary, that is, each has a definite position and zero momentum. This is according to the Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Inconceivable, so I leave it open as a subject for lunchtime conversation exactly how strictly the third law prevents us from ever attaining the absolute zero of temperature. Exercise: if the kinetic temperature of set of hydrogen atom is reduced to a tenth of a nanokelvin, what is the root mean square speed of the atom? That's all. Thanks.